The quota system.
Affirmative action. Transformation in sport. All terms. A process that in its conception aimed to create more adequate demographic representation of athletes in South Africa. Siya Kulisi. Kagiso Rabada. Kasta Semenya. Portia Murise. Tembi Kesana. Marsha Cox. Lucas Hayden. Spoo Ngosi. Select Mons. What if I said we were hindering our national team success rate? What if I said we, as a South African society, were causing a key component vital for peak athletic performance to falter? There are two elements facilitating peak athletic performance, namely the psychological preparation of the athlete and the physical preparation of the athlete. I'd like to share a story with you all. A story of a girl named Zotum. For those of you familiar with the isiZulu language, Zotum was a name depicting prosperity and success. And also Zotum lives up to her name. She's a highly decorated elite athlete with Protea, provincial, and university colors. In addition to this, she's captained both a senior South African ladies tour and a university team. Although the physical elements of being an athlete have been taxing, Zotum would describe how trying the psychological aspects of them. This is as, in the eyes of society, despite her greatest efforts, she has never been consistently viewed as an athlete that is black, but rather a black athlete. Although sounding similar in terminology, an athlete that is black is an athlete whose work ethic and talent supersedes the color of the skin. Whereas a black athlete is an athlete whose predominant role is to fulfill the quota. The term, or back to Zotum. Despite all the accolades she achieved, she developed performance anxiety, a crippling fear of underperforming and disappointing others. Her performance anxiety manifested itself into her intensively watching the clock, because she wanted to escape a situation of which her mind found threatening. Entering her sporting code, she didn't have performance anxiety, but rather developed as she reached higher levels of success. The term PDI came with the first provincial tour. A previously disadvantaged individual is a term used to categorize those who have been denied rights and privileges within South Africa. At the age of 14, she was being told that her place within that team was to rectify the wrongs of the past. Despite this, however, she had an amazing tour as a result of her athletic performance and recalls playing a pivotal role in how well her team performed that year. Her second provincial tour was not as successful. She was suddenly at the mercy of the comments and actions of not only her coach, but also her teammates and their parents. How was she supposed to perform well when, before she's been given the opportunity to perform, before she's been given the opportunity to prove society right, she's been shackled down with a large Q-shaped block around her neck? She was a team quota, and nobody did a good job of hiding it. She played the bare minimum required of a black athlete, and when she was given the opportunity to perform, she could audibly hear her teammates holding their breath. She was sarcastically told, good luck, in a manner in which made it seem as though they were willing for her to fail. How was she supposed to perform more when she's not even being given the opportunity to perform? How was she supposed to achieve individual success if her support structures are willing for her to fail? How is the team supposed to succeed if they are not supporting individual success? So Zodumo describes how the perception of society negatively impeded on her own psychology and how this negatively affected her performance that year. This was undoubtedly her worst tour. So what did she do? She ruled it out as a lack of physical preparation, and she decided to work harder. And similar to her first provincial tour, her third provincial tour, she was again a starter. Despite having an amazing tour and eventually being selected for her first junior South African side, it was during this tour that she realized how easily the public's opinion is swayed within sport. This is as she perceived when she performed well. She was an athlete that was black. However, if she underperformed or just didn't have a good game, she was again reduced to a black athlete. So Dumo further describes how when society's perception shifts from athlete that is black to black athlete, a similar shift happens within the mentality of that athlete. Simple actions ingrained in the muscle memory, the rational but negative mind wants to take over, thus disrupting the natural flow of action. And this is what causes negative performance. The following year, she went on 3 junior South African tours, and the year afterwards, she slowly started to retract herself from sport completely. She hardly went to sporting practices and went sour at the mention of anything sport-related. Her performance anxiety had reached such a state that she was not only questioning her own abilities and questioning her own self-worth, but she was becoming harsh and hostile towards her friends and family. So Dumo was not too sure when her parents realized the extent of her performance anxiety, but a clear indication came when she refused to represent her country that year. Ruling it out as a lack of physical preparation, so Dumo was too afraid, too scared to admit to her friends and family that the psychological aspects of being an athlete that was black was finally catching up to her. She knew why others thought she made teams, and she was deathly afraid of proving them right. As ridiculous as it sounds, at this point, she could hardly sleep and spent many days with a heavy heart and her eye twitching that just wouldn't go away. Having had enough, she emails her father at 3 o'clock in the morning, tears streaming down her face, where she basically describes the root cause of her performance anxiety and how she thought she was just making it up, and how she thought she could just get over it. She ends this email by saying that she's just so tired of this lack of self-confidence, this anxiety, and feeling so small. So what did she do? She began to support herself with the help of a positive support structure, which included a sports psychologist. She did this because she began to realize that nobody within a sporting code was going to be proactive in ensuring that she was psychologically prepared for performance if she was not going to do it herself. And despite proving herself time and time again and time and time again, she's still being subject to comments such as, "I didn't know you're that good," or "you're the team quota," and jokes pertaining to why she makes team. Listening to Zodumo's story, I began to question whether this was an individual issue, an issue pertaining to that specific sporting code, or whether this was a structural problem facing all of South African sport. In an effort to gain understanding, I began to converse with some athlete friends of mine, and this is where I began to realize that all athletes that are black, no matter what sporting code, have all been subjected to the harsh perceptions of society. They, as quotas, have had to create a secret society of sorts, comprising of locker room conversations, where they speak amongst themselves about the mistreatment they felt within South African sports society. Ashwin Mumansa made headlines recently when he stormed off a television broadcasting set. He did this because he perceived that his worth was once again being reduced to that of a quota. In Ashwin Mumansa' international career, he played 29 games, of which he started, meaning he was the number one pick 27 times. Ashwin Mumansa was able to make a career out of his passion as a broadcaster, and this is where he perceived similar to when he was a player, he was a quota in the workplace. Just at the beginning of the year, after poor Protea performance, there was large public outcry with me. At the beginning of the year, after poor Protea performance against Sri Lanka, the whole of South African society began to question the worth of the Protea team. Although the whole team was to blame, Themba Bavuma was subject to a disproportionate amount of criticism, with many on social media calling for him to be the first to be sacked and that he was just a quota player. Themba Bavuma is not a starter, with his batting position being 6 or 7. And out of his 36 games, he scored 1,716 runs. At the beginning of the year, at a local rugby match, the crowd started to chant to the black players, calling them the development players, and some even calling them the K-word. Just under a month ago, a popular South African grocery store was under scrutiny after a cake emerged, with many on social media questioning its appropriateness. This cake was one of two cakes produced on the same day the Springboks took on the New Zealand All Blacks. Each cake adorned its official national emblem with the words New Zealand on the one and the quota squad on the other. Again, I pose this question. How are individuals supposed to achieve success when their support structures are willing for them to fail and are criticizing them every step of the way? How is the team supposed to succeed if they are not supporting individual success? When the quota fails to perform, we forget the immense pressure we've put on the quota. It is so easy to criticize performance when we forget the conditions we told the quota to perform under. The quota is tired of being South African sports society's scapegoat. I am Zodumo. You could be Zodumo. You could know a Zodumo. Zodumo can be sitting in any of our national teams as I speak. I do not know how we begin to rectify this, but what I do know is that these conversations can no longer and should no longer be confined to the locker room. And we all know we can be just a little bit nicer, just a little bit kinder to Zodumo.